Welcome back, friends. Dan Vega here, and today we're going to be talking about building MCP clients using Spring AI. Now, I've covered MCP on this channel, Model Context Protocol. We've talked about it from the standpoint of building MCP servers in Spring AI. And this is really important because when we talk about large language models, they have some limitations. We need to be able to augment them with context, also provide additional functionality. This is great. But what if you're building a client? What if you're building an application that is basically integrating AI into that application, and you need this additional context? You need to be able to pull in these MCP servers, not just one or two, but pull in a bunch of them and add that context or augment the LLM with that additional functionality. That's what we're going to do today. We're going to build a client that uses an MCP server to be able to answer some questions. So I'm over here on the Spring AI documentation. At the time of this recording, the current version of Spring AI is 1.0.3. If you go up here and hit these three little dots, you can go into a preview and select 1.1.0 milestone 3. This is the updated version that has a lot of the simplifications to building MCP servers and clients, makes it a bunch easier. If you're watching this in the future and it's already on 1.1.0 or above, then don't mind that. But if you go in here and you search for MCP client, you can say MCP client, there's the Spring Boot starter there, and you'll get some information on everything you need to know to set up a client. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to pull in an MCP server that I built. Again, as I've alluded to in previous videos, this is a silly example of an MCP server. It's called Dan Vega as a Service. And it really just gives access to all of the content I built, right? So if you go ask a large language model today, what's the latest video Dan Vega created? It's not going to know that. I wasn't trained on that data. I can try to search the web, but often it fails. So I have an MCP server that basically gives you context to the YouTube videos, blog posts, newsletters, where I'm speaking, podcasts, episodes. And so you can start to ask it questions relevant to this type of data. And even in here, I have some examples of how to set an MCP server up using something like Claude Desktop, but this will work wherever MCP servers are supported. And then you could ask it things like, what are Dan's latest Spring Boot tutorials on YouTube? Or what are his last five videos on YouTube? So I talk about this. There's the GitHub repo where you can just see this. And again, I set this up as an example for you to be able to see an MCP server that I built. So I've also went ahead and put this out on the web. So this is at a public server URL. So you could use it in this example that we build today just by using this URL. So that's what we're going to do. So we're going to go over to start.spring.io. We're going to choose the latest version of Spring. I'm going to say dev.danvega. We'll call this DVAS. So Dan Vega as a service, and we'll call it the client. And let's just do this. And then I'm going to pick a couple of dependencies. First, I'm going to pick web because I'm going to have some web endpoints. Then I'm going to go ahead and pick the MCP Model Context Protocol client. And then I'm going to need some type of large language model. Because again, we're building a client, we're using a large language model, and then we're going to augment it using this MCP server. So I'm going to choose OpenAI today, but you can choose whatever large language model you like. With that, we have everything we need. Let's go ahead and download this. So I'll click on Generate. And once that's done, I will open this up in my favorite IDE, which is IntelliJ. You can open up in whatever IDE or text editor you're most efficient in. With that, let's go ahead and write some code. All right, so here we are in our application. I'm going to run this. It's going to fail. We just want to see why. When you set up something with a large language model, most of the time we need to go ahead and set this API key. So I'm going to set an API key up. I'm going to come into application.properties. And in fact, I'm going to rename this to YAML today. It'll just be easier for some of the configuration that we're setting up. So we need to set up a spring.application.name. We'll call this the DVAAS client. And then I need to set up some things specific to OpenAI. So I'll say OpenAI. And actually, all I'm going to set up today is the API key. And you can go ahead and hard code this in. I wouldn't suggest that because we don't want to go ahead and commit that to Git. So I have an environment variable called OpenAI API key. You could also just export this as is, but that will work for me. So now if we go ahead and restart this, I should be able to see it was not set up. So OpenAI API key. Oh, we have the wrong one there. All right, let's try that again. OpenAI API key and OpenAI API key. All right, so that's why I like starting these applications. Make sure that step by step we're doing the right things. Now we can go ahead and talk to OpenAI and ask it questions. But I want to set up my MCP server before we do that, because if we start to ask it questions about my content, it's not going to know. So we need to go ahead and configure a couple of things. So I have my API key. I want to set up some MCP stuff. So MCP, let's set up our client name. So let's say our MCP name is DBAAS MCP client, and maybe our version is something like 0.1 or 0.0.1, and that will give us that. Then we're going to go ahead and say tool callbacks enabled. Yes, we want to enable that tool callback. And then we're going to go ahead and set up what type of MCP servers are we going to integrate in here. So with Spring AI, we have some different transport levels as far as setting up MCP servers, right? There is the STDIO, which is our local standard in and out. There's an SSE version, which is server sent events. And then there's the Streamable, which is now kind of the preferred approach to this. So I'm going to say Streamable, no. Let's get this right, Dan. Streamable. Oh, okay. One thing we need to do, and that's why I wasn't getting that, is we've set this up and we have a version of Spring AI, which is not the version I just showed you. So I'm going to say 1.0 milestone 3. And if we go ahead and refresh this now, we should be able to say Streamable. HTTP, and then our connections. So here's where I'll set up my different servers. So you see this is a map of connections. And so I'm going to set up one called DBAAS. And that server is going to have a URL. And I showed you that URL before. It is https://mcp.danvega.dev/mcp. All right, so we've set up our MCP client, our toolbar, our callbacks enabled, our streamable HTTP connection. If this was STDIO, you can come in here and say STDIO and then set up those connections for those local MCP servers that you set up. So it looks like we're almost done here. Maybe, no, I don't need any logging right now. I think that is good. We got our OpenAI, we have our API key. Looking good. Okay, so now what I can do is start to ask questions to the large language model and feed it some context. But before I do so, I just want to show that in fact, we are bringing in those tools. So the way that I'll do that is I'm going to create a new chat controller, and this is going to be a REST controller. And the first thing I'll need is I'm just going to get a logger, and I'm going to need a chat client. So if you're new here, this is the main interface in Spring AI that allows us to talk to a large language model. Now, there's a chat model, which is kind of the lower level implementation of how it talks to a large language model. The chat client is kind of the public interface. But this is what allows us to write the same code to all of the large language models. So we're not writing something specific to OpenAI here. We've just configured that large language model underneath the hood. If we were to swap that out for something like Anthropic, this code does not change and stays the same. So with that, I'll add a constructor parameter. I need the builder. So builder, I like to call this builder. And from there, we will go ahead and say builder.build. And now we have an instance of the chat client. Okay, now before I do that, I want to just do a couple of things. So what I can get from this is I have this chat client, but what I also want is I want a tool callback provider, and we'll call this tools. And this will give us access to what tools are available, right? So what I want to do is use arrays.stream and we'll take the tools.get tool callbacks, right? And then we'll say for each of those tool callbacks, so we'll say T, and then all I want to do is go ahead and log this out. Tool callback found, tool.get tool definition. So now we have a tool callback found, and then we have our check line. Now we're going to have to add those tools to this, but I just want to see this first so we can see that that MCP server that we configured is actually available and those tools are there. So I'm going to go ahead and restart this. And all right, we have an error. So client failed to initialize by explicit API call. Where are we failing here? Unsupported URI, HTTPS. Did I not put something in there correctly? Ah, so that is a typo, Dan. We don't do typos. Come on. We don't make mistakes. All right. Now, see, as we go through here, now we see all of these tool callbacks. So I have things for like my blog, my newsletter, my podcast, speaking, YouTube. These are all the tools that are now available in this application. But we need to make them available to the chat client itself, right? If we just did this and asked it a question, it wouldn't know. But for this instance of the chat client, I can now say, what are the default tool callbacks? And I can just pass it in the tool. Actually, I don't even need that. I just need tools, right? So default tool callbacks, those are the tools. And then if I wanted to, I can add default like system messages. If I wanted to set something like, hey, you are only answering questions about Dan Vega, I can set a default system level message, but we're not going to do that now. Now I can come in here and create a Git mapping. So let's call this slash chat. And what we're going to do is use that chat client. So I'm going to return a string. We'll call this chat. And in this chat, I'm going to take in a message. Actually, we won't even do that. Let's just say return chat client. So chat client dot prompt. I'm going to give it a user message. So we'll just give it a string and we'll say, what are Dan Vega's latest YouTube videos? Now, we could go through the song and dance of if you go out to OpenAI and ask it this question, or if I didn't define these tools here, it's not going to produce the best result. Maybe it does some searching of the web. In this case, it won't because I haven't provided it that tool. But if you went out to like chatgpt.com and did that, yes, it could probably search the web, but it won't give you an exact response that we're looking for. So I'm going to say .call, and then I'll go ahead and just get the string content back. Again, this call is a blocking call. If you wanted to, you can change this method to stream and get a streaming response back. With that, I think I have everything I need to go ahead and test this out. So let's go ahead and rerun this. Everything looks the same. I'm going to go over to my terminal. And you can do this because it's a GET request. You could probably just open up a browser and go to slash chat. But I'm using a nice little utility called HTTPy. I really mess that up every single time. I don't know what's wrong with me. So I'm going to just say dot chat. And hopefully it's going to use that default message. It's going to use the tools that we've provided it. And now hopefully can answer that question for us, which is what is Dan Vega's latest videos? So here's the latest videos. How to secure MCP servers with Spring Security, thanks to my conversation with Daniel Garnier-Moreau. Claude Code, I've done a couple of videos on. Vibe coding, MCP with Spring AI in minutes. So yes, those are my last videos. And if you wanted to, you can go ahead and click on this link to get them, because building out this MCP server, I was able to add that context to it. So I hope you found that useful. Again, I love building MCP servers to add that additional context or capabilities to our applications. Whenever you find yourself saying, oh, I need to add some context to the application, put it into an MCP server so you can repackage that and use it in multiple clients. You could use my MCP server in something like Claude Desktop or on the web or at ChatGPT that now supports MCP servers, but you can also build your own clients. I'm building an application to hopefully perform a task. Maybe I can stitch a few of these MCP servers, like the ability to maybe write to a file system, maybe one to like, hey, I'm writing a blog post. Go ahead and take a look at this. Create a summarization for me. Do some grammar and spell checking. See if there's ways we can improve the SEO on this article. Again, you can start to stitch these MCP servers together using this MCP client here. And again, APIs are for services. So APIs are for talking to services from clients. MCPs are for LLMs. They are a way to provide a model agnostic way of augmenting that context. And that's what we've done here today. We could swap this out from OpenAI to Anthropic to Google Gemini, and this would just work because we're using that MCP server I built. So, hey, I hope you found this useful. If you did and you learned something new today, I love learning. I hope you do too. I hope you learned something new today. And if you did, do me a big favor, friends, leave me a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and as always, happy coding.